Welcome back to the I'd Love to Be There series. Today we're going to be talking about Soundtrap and all of the incredible things you can do with Soundtrap, but very quickly, within just 10 minutes, okay? Remember, this series is all about some of the incredible things that are happening at Bett, and for all those people that couldn't make it to Bett, we're putting this on for you. So let's jump straight in. I'm really excited for this one. I'll see you in just 2 seconds down on the little... down on the little screen. Okay, so here we are. We are on Soundtrap right now. All you need to do to get started is log in. So we are going to create our very first sound. So on the left, we're going to enter the studio. So now that that's loaded up, we can choose to either make music or a podcast. Today, we're going to be making music, okay? So let's go into music. So what do we do now? Well, up at the top, the first thing is always we need to save and we need to name our new project. So I'm going to call mine Niles Song and I'm going to hit save up on the top left. Okay, so we've got lots of different options here for if we were wanting to create our own track and record it and come up with the notes ourselves, but today we're just going to have a look at the loop library. So down at the bottom we've got loop library and we can now start adding in the loops. So let's go for a little bit of guitar to start off with, and we can sample these loops by pressing the play button. That sounds good. So all I'm going to do is I'm going to click and I'm going to drag that in to where I want it to go. So right there. So there's our first part. Down at the bottom we can press play. We can record if we want to record ourselves using the microphones. You can adjust the sound, you can adjust the key, the tempo, the metronome, that kind of stuff, and play about with those settings yourself. So now that we've got the guitar in there, let's add in some drums. So I'm just going to click on the drums button and we're going to choose some drums here. So let's have a little play around. So let's add vertigo in. So we're going to pop that in at the start. Okay, so I've zoomed in just a little bit there for us just so that we can see a little bit better. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pull the wee dragger up at the top where you can choose where you're going to play from. And all I'm going to do is select where I want to cut the drums from. I'm then going to right click and I'm going to hit split region. Then I'm going to click on the bit that I don't want and tap delete from my keyboard. Now when I play, I'm going to have just the guitar and then just the drums and the guitar together. Okay, so that's how you do that. So now let's add in another new track. Again, we can do them from here if we want to put in our own ones, or we can go straight to the loop library over on the right hand side. So let's clear drums and this time let's add in some bass. So you'll see here it does say any scale, so any major scale or any minor scale. I can see that we are in F sharp minor, so we'll be aiming for a minor scale there, okay? And then it does recommend some things as well for you. Let's add this one in. And again, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to the end of the second bar and I'm going to split. There we go. So now we have our track here. So let's add in a little bit of audio. Okay, so I'm going to use the voice in the microphone here and I'm going to record myself just making noise over the top of the sound. So I recommend for this part that you turn down the sound on your device so it doesn't come through the microphone, or keep the microphone well away from the speakers, or use headphones if you like. Okay, so we're just going to do that. So we're just going to record ourselves making some noise. It's going to give you a little countdown. So I'm just going to stop it there. We can pull it to adjust to the right number of bars that we want to play from. Okay, and then let's listen back. So you'll be able to hear that. We can also adjust how the microphone sounds. We can increase the reverb, put the panning to the right, what way is right on here, that way, right or left, okay, And lastly, you can adjust the volume as well. So now that we have our song, what do we want to do with it? Well, the first thing we want to do is save. Now you'll notice that now that it's saved, it is mixing the track in together. So it's going to create that MP3 for us. And once it is done mixing, we can now download the MP3 file as well. We can also share this in other ways. So we've got over here, we've got the share and we've got share up here. So I can share this with people's email addresses or I can enter their names. I can copy the link and get them to join in and collaborate with me. We can also use a guest on a podcast as well, and we can create a call and it will record what we're both saying. Over on the right hand side as well, this is where you can see all the collaborators and you can invite people to come and edit your song with you, or you can start a video call with them. So that is Soundtrap very quickly. I hope that you've learned something new. I'll see you on the big screen in just 2 seconds. Thank you so much for joining us today on the I'd Love to Be There series. I know that not everybody can make it to Bett, so that's why we're putting on these little short videos just to bring some of the best of Bett to you. We've not been there yet when we're recording these, so I'm really excited to see what is new and what people are talking about whilst we are there. Thank you so much for joining us today on Soundtrap. I hope you've learned something new, and I'll see you tomorrow on our next video. Cheers. Bye.